Meet Jimmy the Iron Bull. He's talented. He's a man of the people. He's cool, calm, and collected.
Yeah, I did, but the motherfucker wants to move my basement. He's coming back from California. Fucking find a fucking house in the fucking school district, right? Otherwise, I'd fucking move out of this motherfucking state. I'm going down to fucking Carolina or some shit.
What the fuck is that?
Who's cleaning my fucking window? You got some fucking sheet. Fucking thing was this big, bro.
Oh, look. This cocksucker goes around.
$250 for the fucking wheel lock? Fucking kidding me? Fucking Mike. I should fuck like for my fucking mother. I'm going to flip the fuck out. I'm going to kill the first motherfucker who will fight. What do you mean? 3 fucking months ago, my insurance. And store is too. You fucking cocksuckers. I said I'll call all my friends, right?
And he's going to be live this Thursday night on Heavy Muscle TV. Don't miss Jimmy the Iron Bull with your host, Dave Palumbo, and the rest of the crew this Thursday night at 7:30 on the all-new 24/7 RX TV on RXMuscle.com.
Yeah, right!
Welcome back to another exciting episode of the Heavy Muscle TV Show. It is April 3rd, 2014, and we're here live in Westbury, New York, in the RX Muscle Studios. We're back here with the with a good crew we have today. I have our station manager, Sid, to my right. To my left, I have Jimmy the Angry Bull, who last week made quite a spectacle on the show. We have IFBB Pro Eugene Mission back and his lovely wife, our good friend Lena.
Hi.
But Jimmy, I have to go to you initially first because people saw the intro.
Yeah.
You kind of lost your mind a little bit last week. I have to tell you, though, I've received so many texts and emails from people telling me it was quite possibly the funniest thing they had ever seen. They could not believe. Someone in physical therapy actually came up to me and said, I can't believe that this was not made up.
No,
but they said, there's no way anyone can make it up because it was so crazy.
No, yeah, it wasn't made up. Yeah. Well, that's the beauty about my life. You know, it's all reality.
The vest was a good touch you came with, that reflective vest, because it really showed the level of, like, you just literally got out of the truck and came here.
Well, I literally did. I mean, I came straight from work. But I mean, that's why I was running a little late that night. But,
Now, what people don't realize is that you still had to go and pick up the truck. You hadn't done that when you were telling us the story yet.
Well, that really shouldn't happen to anybody, okay? Because what happened was, after I got a ride home from my good friend Cassie, who owns a butcher shop in Queens, she came and got me, and I got home. So the next morning.
You were lucky.
I was actually lucky because she was at work and she was able to come get me. So anyway, make a long story short, I had to go the next day to get the car. I figured, okay, no big deal. We'll get the fucking car, right?
Now, before you get to the story.
Yeah.
I haven't heard the story. So anyone who might ask, I don't know what would happen. Did it get worse?
Yeah, it actually did get worse.
I didn't think it was possible.
I almost lost it the next day.
I said, tell us what happened.
Because it was like a continuation from the day before. So it went into the next day. So it was like 2 days of fucking horror.
So who drives you to who drives you to Queens?
Well, the next morning I had to go to motor vehicle, because before I went to Queens, I had to pay up the fines at motor vehicle.
Oh, you did have fines on the car.
Well, I did, because what happened was when in New York, I don't know about other states, but over here, when if you lapse on your insurance for 2-3 days, whatever it is, motor vehicle, the insurance company notifies motor vehicle and immediately suspend your registration, and they start fining you fucking $8-$9 a day.
Uh-huh. Okay, so how much did that cost you?
It wasn't that bad. It was only $64. They towed my car for $64.
How long did it take you to get into motor vehicles and get through the whole process?
Well, it was big. I went early in the morning, okay. So I figured, you know what? I went in there and I paid everything, and the lady gave me all the proper paperwork. She gave me the new Reggie with the lift, you know, off of it, and I paid the fines and all that bullshit. Yeah. And then I had, because I paid on the phone in Queens at the site where they booted my car,
right.
I paid it all the fines there, and they gave me a confirmation number. So I had the confirmation number. I had all this fucking paperwork, right? So Cassie was like, hurry up, I got to get to work. And she had to be at work at 10 o'clock. So I made it in and out of motor vehicles. I was like, oh, this is cool. I'm going to have a good day.
Yeah.
So she drops me off to the New York. That's right. I had to go to her job. She dropped herself off. I took her car.
She was hoping that, you know, by dropping you off, obviously you're assuming you're getting your car back, right?
Well, she didn't drop me off. What happened was I took her to her job, okay. You know, her butcher shop, and I took her car to go all the way on the South Shore of Queens in Jamaica to go to the New York Finance Building to pay the fine and show to get my car released.
But how could you get the car released if you have another car?
Well, what I was going to do was, it was very complicated. The whole day was very complicated because, you know, I had to get a ride, right? So I figured we get you know, drop her off, take her car, go pay the fines, come back, pick her up. She'd take me to College Point Boulevard and drop me off, and I can get my car and drive home.
So it's basically a whole day affair, basically.
Well, it wouldn't have been a whole day affair if this fucking New Yorkers out of their fucking minds, all right? So what happened was, I figured, no big deal. I drive a little bit of traffic, no big deal. I get over to fucking New York State Financing, right? I walk in. I parked my car. I couldn't get a spot, so I saw the parking garage, right? I only had $20 in my pocket.
You didn't get a ticket or anything, did you?
No, I didn't want. That's why I was like, you know what? Let me park in the garage because I ain't getting no more fucking. I stopped at every red light. Yeah, I was like, you know what? Let me park in the garage. You know, so I only had like $20 on me at this point. I'm fucking broke, right? So I go into the parking lot, and there's a little guy in a wooden box. You know, I said, excuse me, how much to park the car? He goes, $10 for an hour. I says, okay. I says, I shouldn't be more than an hour. He goes, over an hour, over $25. I said, no problem. I'll be in and out of here. I got to go to the New York State Finance Building. Okay. So I fucking leave. Right? I go into the New York State Finance Building. 300 fucking people, right?
What?
It's packed, right? So I get in there. I'm looking around. I'm like, holy shit. Look at all these fucking people. I said, this is some fucking business I got over here.
What time was this?
This is like fucking like 11 o'clock in the morning.
Don't people work?
Bro, the place was packed. So I go in there, and right away this officer comes over to me and says, because he sees me looking around with all the paperwork and shit, you know. And Cassie made me a roast beef sandwich, right?
Thank God you had.
Because I was starved. I had this big roast beef sandwich. Eugene, you would love it. It was this fucking big, right? So I had it in a paper bag, and I'm carrying this fucking thing around. So the cop comes right over to me. He goes, can I help you? I says, yeah. I says, I just got to get my car released. I got a boot on it. He goes, well, your car ain't here. I says, I know my car ain't here. I says, I got to pay fines. I got to show that I paid the registration and motor vehicle. I says, please. You know. He goes, all right, let me see. He's looking at all my paperwork, you know. He's like, yeah, okay, yeah. You got to get on line B. He goes, take a ticket and go sit in the chair and wait on line B. I said, this is going to be a long time? He goes, no, it's not too bad today. That's okay. So I go over and I sit in the chairs. All the chairs are facing the screen, right? Where the number comes up?
Sure.
I'm facing the A screen. The fucking B screen's back here. All the seats are this way. So all for 3 hours, I got to look behind me to see the fucking B screen. Right. Why do you put the B screen back there? All the fucking seats are going this way.
Right.
I don't understand. So everybody, every nation is there and I just fucking play. I'm talking all kinds of fucking languages and shit, right? So finally, I get up to the, they call the number, so I run up to the window.
How long did it take before they called your number?
An hour and a half, right? Oh. So I'm sweating, I'm texting, I don't know what to do with myself, right? Yeah. Babies are crying. I'm like, I said, why me, man? Why? So I finally, no, I didn't want to eat the sandwich at this point because everybody's staring at me. I don't know if they're going to attack me because there was like so many people there. Everybody was like waiting for the, you know, it's a very intense place,
sure,
you know?
Sure.
So I go to the window and the lady says, I says, hi, ma'am. I says, I'm here to get my car. I got all the paperwork here. She's looking at my purse. She goes, well, your car's not here. I says, I know my car's not here. I says, I came here to pay the towing and the storage and all that good stuff. Right. And here's all my paperwork. I says, I paid the fines. You know, she goes, where'd you pay the fines? I says, I paid them on the phone. She says, what's your name? I said, James Pellecci. You know, she's looking up. She's
they
looking
purposely try to get you all nervous.
I don't know what it is. So then, you know, I swear to God, Dave, it's not a long story, but I got to tell it.
Yeah.
So now she's on the computer, right? I hate when they do it. She turns around and you're like, well, here is this here, you know, the fucking thing, right? And I'm waiting like this for 5 minutes, you know. And all of a sudden she says, I'm sorry, James, I don't see it on the board here.
Oh.
I said, listen, I paid it on the phone. I said, I got the confirmation number. Here, this is the confirmation. So she takes it and she's looking at the computer. She's typing. She goes, I don't see it. I said, listen, ma'am, nothing. I says, you know, I have to get the car today. could you please look a little harder? You know, so she's finally looking and looking. 20 minutes, she left. Then she came back. Oh, now another lady comes over, and they're all looking at my paperwork. And I'm going, what the fuck is the problem? They told me to come here. Here's the papers. I'm here. I got the registration. I got everything. Now it's like fucking 1 o'clock, right? I'm sweating. Right now I got to get my goddamn car to the parking fucking garage because I only have $20 in my fucking car. So anyway, the fucking lady.
So in other words, you don't have enough money to pay.
No, now I don't. No, so now I go, I'm at the window. I go, lady, I go, man, please. I says, just, you know, so finally she goes, did you pay with a debit or a credit card? I said, I pay with a credit card. I said, it's got to be on it. It was $700. I paid for the goddamn boot, too. I said, $750. I want to pay the towing and the storage so I could go get my car. So finally she says, oh, yeah, I think I see it. And she's typing it up and blah, 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 blah. And then she leaves again and she comes back. I said, is this being done on purpose to me? I said, really, man? You know, I don't have – is somebody testing my fucking patience? You know, so finally she comes back. She goes, okay, James. She goes, how are you going to pay for the towing and the storage? I said, well, my credit card, you know. She says, is that a Visa? So I look at the card. I go, yeah, it's a Visa. She goes, the Visa machine's down today.
Wow. Oh, my God.
So all of a sudden, like, I don't know if you could see it, but, like, probably, like, sparks are coming out of my fucking ear. And I'm, like, fucking short-circuiting. And I'm going, the Visa machine is down.
What machine is
working? There's 300 fucking people here.
What machine is working?
I don't know. I said, your Visa machine is down. What does that mean? She says, we can't accept your card. I said, what am I supposed to do now? I said, I got to get the car today. I need my fucking car.
Yeah.
She says, well, there's an ATM down the street. I said, it's pouring rain out there. I got to go out. She says, that's the only way we could do it. I says, all right, so then I go get the cash and I can pay it. She goes, you get the cash.
How much money did you have to pay?
I was $180 or something. I had, you know, so.
Thank God you have money in your cash.
I put money in the bank on purpose, you know, the company. I didn't bring much money with me on it, you know. Sure. So anyway. I go walking all the way down. I go to this supermarket. It was like I was like in another country, like right? Some fucking Jamaica. So I go in there, and I'm through the cash machine. You know, I'm counting my money like this because this place is a bad neighborhood, right? Yeah. I mean, they got like fucking steel bars right outside the supermarket, so you can't steal the goddamn cart. All right,
yeah.
So. I get out. I walk back. Now I'm soaked. I go back to the fucking.
Pouring
it. It was pouring like that. It was pouring. So I had my fucking roast beef sandwiches all fucked up, right? My paper bag, right? Because I'm still carrying that motherfucker. Because I didn't eat it yet.
Yeah.
But I'm starving. But I wanted to say, I thought I was going to be in my car by now.
Yeah.
Driving, eat my fucking sandwich on my way home. Right. Happy, right? No. So I go back to the fucking window. I says, okay, ma'am. I says, I'm back. She said I could come right back.
Yeah,
I didn't have to wait on that line. You know, so I says, because there was another line. Yeah. It was like a couple different lines going on. So I went back to the window. I says, here you are, ma'am. Here's the money. Here's the cash. Okay, James. She goes, you got $180? I says, yes, I do. Right here. Okay. She goes, okay. We don't take it here. I says, where do you take it? I wanted to say, in your fucking ass, you motherfucker. Where do you take the money? I said, you told me to get the cash, didn't you? And come back. And here I am with the fucking cash. Here it is, $180. She goes, no. She goes, you got to go on the cashier line. So I look, and I said, there's 200 people on that fucking line. I said, you're kidding me, right, ma'am? I said, can you just do it here? Do me a solid. Just please, just take the fucking money. She goes, no. She goes, here. She goes, she gives me another receipt, the registration. All that. Now I got to go stand on line.
No.
Right? So I go all the way to the fucking line. I'm standing on the fucking line. I'm waiting. I'm fucking things moving slow
as
shit.
Did you eat the sandwich yet?
I didn't want to eat it yet. I'm still, it was all, that was all like the paper bag was falling apart. It was all fucked up, right? I'm holding the money. I had tons of paperwork.
Yeah.
You know, registration, inspections, fucking confirmation numbers of the fucking sheets, the towing, all the, right? So, I swear, I'm going to be on medication soon. So.
How long did it take you to get to the cashier window?
On the line?
Yeah.
It was like another fucking hour and 15
what?
Minutes. So now now I'm saying to myself, now besides the fucking the cars in the lot, now I probably gotta go to the ATM machine again. Now the traffic, Cassie's gotta get her car back, and I still gotta go get the
you
fucking
car, the
car in fucking College Point Boulevard, right? So I get online, I finally get up, there's a little Chinese guy at the window. I says, hi. I knock on the window. I said, hello. I says, I'm here to pay this. Storage and the towing. So he don't even answer. So I just slide it under. The window's like this. I got to slide everything. All this shit under this fucking window, right? So he looks at it. I put the cash in there, you know. And he's looking at all my paperwork. He's on the fucking thing, you know. I hate when they do that, man. He's doing this here, you know. I feel like, come on with that fucking thing, you know. So anyway, now the motherfucker has got to count the money, right? So he's going like this.
Ha, ha, ha. Someone was and testing. Someone was testing.
The head's
you.
That way. The head's that way, right?
He's testing your patience.
He's doing all the heads in the same direction. And I'm watching him. And he's doing like this. And then after he got all the heads the right way, which took 5 to 7 fucking minutes because he's Chinese, he takes the money and he folds it like this. And then he starts to count it again. What? Because after he straightened it, he wasn't counting it when he was straightening the heads out. He straightened it out first. Then he had to count the fucking money. And he's going like this, this little fucking 90-pound Chinese motherfucker. I wanted to kill him, right? And he's counting like that. And I'm looking at him like this. And he's got to see that I'm losing my fuck. I said, this is insane. This is, you know. So finally, he gets all the money, and he goes like this. Then he turns around, and he gets a clip, and he's clipping it. Then he puts it down, and he stamps it, like, with the sting. Then he grabs this pen, and he goes like this.
Every bill?
Every fucking bill. I only got tens out of the goddamn 8 years. It wasn't even 20s. It was tens. So now he's going like, this is the fucking pen, right? And I'm standing there with my melted roast beef, fucking old French, wet. My fucking balls is, I'm soaked. And this fucking Chinese fuck is going like this here with every fucking bill, right? And I'm looking, I'm going, there's something wrong here. This guy has got to be kidding me. No wonder there's a fucking line of 300 people. Yeah. Look at the fucking way you guys are conducting business in this fucking shithole. I can't take it anymore. So he gets it all, he fucking puts it in the drawer, and then the fucking cocksucker turns around, he goes like this. I said, no shit. He goes like this with the receipt, like out the window, the little slot like that. And I'm standing here, and the fucking thing comes out like that, right on the table. I go, and I said, he was looking at the computer. I said, excuse me, is this it?
Yeah.
That was after fucking 20 minutes of that. That's what he did. Okay, thank you. Right, fuck like that. Go downstairs. I had to go to the ATM, get another $40 out.
How much was the parking?
I don't know, it was fucking like $45, right? Oh my God. I go back there. There's a little Spanish guy in the box. I said, hi, sir. I says, can I get my car? Yeah, he goes, $45, right? I give him the fucking money. I said, here, there's an extra $5. I said, hey, go get some lunch, right?
Did you really?
Yeah, at this point, I didn't give a fuck. So I go get the car. I shoot all the way on the other side of Queens, back to the expressway, to Cassie's butcher shop.
What time is this now?
Oh, it gets better. So now, this is like 3:30, almost 4 o'clock, right?
Holy, you've been going since 8 in the morning.
Early, all day, this, right? Yeah. So I get over there. I said, Cassie.
Have you eaten a
sandwich
yet?
Did you eat your sandwich yet, Jim? I said, no, I didn't eat my sandwich at Cassie. I said, look at it. I said, it fucking looks like I went to war. I said,
I just want to eat anything all day yet.
Not yet. Because I'm tense. I want to get my car.
Right.
If I don't get it, it would have stayed in storage all weekend.
And you have to pay again.
I would have had to pay storage all fucking weekend, right?
Yeah.
So she takes me over. She goes, where's this place? I said, I don't know, 1346 College Point Boulevard. She's trying to put it in her GPS. I said, Cassie, just go to College Point Boulevard. I said, we'll find it, right? So we take off, we go, right? All of a sudden, we get to the College Point Boulevard. It took about 20 minutes to get there. Yeah. I said, there's the bill. It's pouring rain, right? She got the wipers on. I go, is that the... She goes, is that it? I said, yeah, I think that's it, Cassie. All right, she goes, I'm going to drop you off. You're going to be all right? I said, yeah, that's the building. It says fucking New York State, fucking whatever. Look at all the cars. There's the fucking chain link fence, barbed wire. This has got to be the place. She drops me off. I got my fucking roast beef sandwich. And I waved to her. I said, you know, she takes off, right?
Oh, no. All right.
So I go around the gate, you know.
Pouring, right?
Pouring rain. I go into this fucking trailer. Two women in the window again, you know. And I says, hi. I says, I'm here to get my car. She goes, well, where is it? I said, I thought it was here. I said, they told me to come here. I got all the paperwork. She goes, well, did the marshals take it or the sheriff take it? Or who? I says, well, I said, I don't know who the fuck took it. I said, they had a boot on it. Oh, you had the boot? I says, yeah. Well, she goes, that's the building down three, four blocks. I says, so it's not here? She goes, no. So she gives me all my paperwork back, right? So I get all my paperwork back, my fucking sandwich, and I start walking. I go out of the building. I'm walking down College Point Boulevard. It's pouring rain, trucks flying by, fucking all this shit, right? I get to this fucking chain link fence. I see the cars, and I see these guys in there. I don't even know how to get in the fucking place, right? So finally, I walk around this trail. I go down this dirt fucking hill, and I make it look like a fucking junkyard, right? I fucking get to this fucking gate that's closed and locked. And I see this gentleman standing there, you know? So I walk up, my sandwich over shit, you know? And I says, and I'm looking around, and I'm like, hello? You know? all of a sudden, this guy comes, this Haitian, he must be from another country, comes out of the car. He lives in his car. There was like Chinese boxes on his dashboard, newspapers, toilet paper, a fucking TV. The motherfucker lives in his car, right? So he gets out, and he comes to the gate. I says, hi. I says, I want to, he goes, nope. And he walks in, and he goes back to his car.
What?
So I swear to God, on my father's grave, this is what happened to me, right? So I said, wait. I says, what? So then the guy turns around, that's next to him. He goes, yo, cuz. I said, what's up with this dude? He goes, man, I was here all day yesterday. He goes, they didn't even want to talk to you.
What?
I says, what are you talking about? He goes, they don't want to talk to you. He goes, if they feel like talking to you, they'll talk to you. He goes, otherwise, they're not going to talk to you. He goes, I said, you were here all day yesterday? He goes, yeah, I had to come back today.
What?
I said, you were here all day yesterday to get your car, and you had to come back today? He goes, yeah. I said, you fucking, tell me you're joking, man. It's 4:30. It's raining. I got to get my fucking car. He goes, I'm telling you, these guys are scumbags, man. So I'm fucking, now I'm got the jump going, hello, hello, right, the fucking guy comes out, he's yelling at me in some language, he goes back in his car, I see another guy pulling out with a tow truck, all of a sudden the guy gets out, he opens the gate, he says, oh, thank God, he opens the gate, so I'm standing there with the paperwork in my fucking roast sandwich, and the tow truck guy just drives by, right, and then the guy closes the gate again, locks it. The fuck kind of place is this, man? I just want to get my fucking car.
I can't believe
it. I swear to God. So now I'm standing again, and the guy's talking to me. He goes, this place is fucked up. I said, bro, it's getting dark. I'm going to be standing. I got to walk home. I didn't have a fucking ride out of here. He goes, I know, man. He goes, look. He goes, hopefully they'll.
But why wouldn't they let you in?
They're scumbags, dude. They don't care.
They purposely want to keep it another day.
They're purposely scumbags. They know you're out there where you paid. They know you're there to get your car. And they don't want to fucking talk to you, give you the right time of day. You could stand out there if you had a fucking Mercedes in there. They wouldn't give two shits. So, they treat you like garbage.
So if you would. Right? Hold on. If you didn't get in there and you would have had it, they kept it all weekend, you would have had to go back to that building and pay another fine, right?
For the storage. I would have had to go back all the way to fucking Jamaica, pay the storage, and go back again.
Right. So how'd you get in?
So finally, I'm yelled two, three times, this fucking guy walking around, right? So now, here's the real fun part, right? So I'm standing there talking to the guy.
I'm surprised you haven't killed someone.
This is like, I was turning purple. All of a sudden, I hear the gate open up, and I'm talking to the guy, and I'm trying to ignore this dude now, because I'm thinking, maybe if I don't look at him, I'm fucking, you know. And I'm talking to the guy, and all of a sudden, I feel this thing, like, pecking my fucking leg, right? And I turn around, like, what the fuck is... it's fucking roosters, man.
What?
The guy has roosters in the fucking roosters, fucking... I said, what? I said, what the fuck? So this guy's laughing. I go, this guy... fucking roosters on me over here.
What?
So the guy's laughing at me, the gatekeeper.
What are they, voodoo guys?
I don't know. Yeah, it's like they come from out of Hades or some shit. So I'm kicking the fucking rooster. I said, look at that. I'm getting attacked by fucking roosters now. I can't get my car. I said, what the fuck is going on in here? Right, so the fucking tow truck pulls up. And I fucking bang it on the guy's door. And he rolls his window. He's a real scumbag, you know.
Yeah.
And I look, I said, look, pal, I don't know if you guys are doing this shit on purpose. I said, this guy with the gate, the roosters, I really can't take it. I just got to get my fucking car. Please. I just want to go home. Please, just get my fucking car. He goes, so he takes off, closes the door. All of a sudden, 10 minutes later, some guy comes out of the trailer. And he goes, the same guy, the gatekeeper.
Yeah.
He goes, so I go, here, right? I don't know what he said. I just came home. But I did have a receipt in my pocket. Yeah. And in my back pocket, I had the Reggie, the updated Reggie, right? So 10, 15 minutes later, he comes out again. I said, what? What are you saying? He goes, I said, registration? What? Receipt? Here. I said, here. I've got a fucking receipt here somewhere. I said, oh, here it is. Here. Here's a receipt. He goes back in the fucking trailer. I swear to God, Dave.
How long you're in
10
the
minutes later, he comes back out. He's going, I said, listen, man, I'm out of disrespect. I said, what's your name? He goes, Mimi. I said, Mimi, I gotta get my fucking car, Mimi. What do you need? I gave you every fucking thing. He's going, I said, so I'm trying to think what I got left, what that could possibly be saying.
Yeah.
I said, registration? I said, yeah, I might have. So I'm looking for my registration. I said, dear God, please, maybe it's in my roast beef sandwich. I start looking at him. I had the roast beef sandwich in the car.
Are you outside in the rain?
I'm outside in the rain. I'm fucking digging in my fucking roast beef bag. I all of a sudden I find it. It's all fucked up. I go, yeah, my fucking Reggie. He takes the Reggie, comes back out. They open the gate, right? I'm like, oh, my God. I go in the trailer, and the guy's standing there like this, right? And I come in, I'm standing next to the desk, and the guy throws the paper.
He
goes, sign here. I said, that's it? He goes, yeah. He goes, okay, your car's outside. I said, why couldn't this have been done 2 hours ago?
Right.
It's fucking 6 o'clock. I said, are you kidding me?
He goes, I apologize.
It was 6 o'clock?
Yeah, I said, thank you. So I go out, I get my car. You know, the other guy who was standing by the gate says, check your car. I didn't give a fuck. I didn't care if it was
12 hours you've been up. You haven't eaten anything.
I haven't eaten nothing. So I get in the car and I fucking take off. As soon as I got on the expressway, I took that fucking soaked fucking roast beef that I just I just started fucking. People driving by me, I just see me fucking lapping this fucking tearing. I was tearing it. It looked like flesh. I was tearing the sandwich apart. Because I was livid, man. Livid.
Wow.
That was it.
What time did you make it home?
I got home about 7:30, 8 o'clock.
Oh, my God. What a nightmare. Johnny Styles, what are you asking me? Oh, Johnny Styles says, you've gone so long that we need to take a break.
That was the whole story. I had to tell the whole story.
I liked it.
Nobody could even imagine what the fuck I went through.
I canceled half the guests just to hear this story tonight. And it was a good one. Guys, stay tuned. More Jimmy the Bull in 2 minutes.